The normal distribution is one of the most common distributions used in probability theory. Sometimes we refer to the normal distributions as the Gauss curve, after the German mathematician Friedrich Gauss, or the bell curve because of its shape. Many natural phenomena are normally distributed. Think of heights of persons, IQ scores, birth weights of babies, and so on. In this video, we will explain some of the basic concepts of the normal distribution and will show how to construct a normal distribution graph in Excel. The Excel exercise will help us to get a better understanding of the normal distribution. The normal distribution has a symmetrical shape and the graph reflects itself in the vertical axis at the mean. Usually, the normal distribution is defined by the mean or average and the standard deviation. The mean describes the distribution center and the standard deviation is an indicator of how dispersed the data are. In our example, the mean is 500 and the standard deviation 1500, which is high. The standard deviation is often presented using the lowercase Greek letter sigma. Another characteristic of a normal distribution is that the range defined by two standard deviations to the left of the mean, and to the right of the mean, contains 95% of all the data or observations. Let's take a look. In our example, the standard deviation equals 1500. Twice the sigma gives us 3000. The mean is at 500. So, two sigmas to the left and two sigmas to the right define the range between minus 2500 and positive 3500. Now let's take a closer look at the graph. If we take the whole area, we cover 100% of the data or observations. If we position our cursor in the middle or the mean, at the value 500, then 50% of the data are to the left, and 50% to the right of the cursor. This position of the cursor at the 50% mark corresponds with a value of 500 on the horizontal x-axis. We could repeat this process and, starting on the left hand, cover stepwise 10, 20, 30 and so on percent of the area of the graph. Each of these percentages corresponds with a value on the x-axis. We could also turn this around and pick a value on the x-axis and see what percentage of the graph surface is covered. We already saw that a value of 500 corresponds with 50% of the surface and, for instance, 880 with 60%. So, we can approach this from two directions. There are two Excel functions that perform these calculations. Let's start with the normal distribution function, which takes three inputs. The value on the x-axis for which we would like to know the corresponding surface percentage, the mean, and the standard deviation. Moreover, we need to indicate that we like to see cumulative values, which means that we measure the surface starting from the left up to the point on the x-axis selected. So, the last element of our function is true. We recall that the mean was 500 and the standard deviation 1500. If we do this for the value 880, which we have used earlier as an example, we find 0.6 or 60%. Keep in mind that these values might differ slightly due to rounding. At this moment, we need to remind you that the percentage found represents a probability. After all, the normal distribution is a probability distribution. In our example, the percentage found means that there is a 60% probability of the value being smaller than 880, and a 40% chance that the value is higher than 880. Now we go to Excel again and take the percentage or probability as an input and generate the corresponding value on the x-axis. This is what the normal inverse function does. It is an inverse function because it works in the opposite direction of the normal distribution function. If we enter 60% and the mean and standard deviation, we find 880. Now we understand these two Excel functions and it is time to turn to our Monte Carlo simulator. If we would enter random probabilities in the normal inverse function, we will get random x-axis values. Excel has a built-in random value generator. The random function generates random values in the range of 0 and 1. Notice that we do not have to put in anything between the parentheses. Next step is that we will include or nest this random function in the normal inverse function. The function will generate random x-axis values for a normal distribution with a mean of 500 and a standard deviation of 1500. We can do this 10,000 times by copying the formula. While copying, make sure to freeze the references to the mean and standard deviation using dollar signs. Copying this function 10,000 times will generate 10,000 random x-axis values. Since we used the Excel normal distribution function, these values will also be normally distributed. We can perform some basic statistical analyses. To make this easier, we assign a name to the data range of our simulated data in the top left corner. We name this range simulated result. Using this name, we can quickly find the basic statistics, for instance the average. Not surprisingly, we find values for the mean or average and the standard deviation that are close to the numbers we started with. To better understand how the concept of a normal distribution works, we will create a graph using the simulated data. Such a graph is a frequency distribution. The higher the frequency for a certain value range, the higher the probability, and the taller the graph at that point. To count the number of occurrences, we first need to define the ranges. It helps to see what minimum and maximum values are to define the bin range. We opted for bins with a size of 500 in the range between minus 5000 and positive 8000. Again, we assign a name to the data range in the upper left corner, bin simulated results. Now everything is in place to count the number of observations in each of the bins. We do this using the Excel frequency function. The only thing we need to enter is the data range and the bin range. Since we assigned names to these ranges, this is easy to do. Excel will fill the table with the results automatically. In case you are using an older Excel version, you might have to highlight the destination area and click on Alt Control and Enter simultaneously to perform this calculation. Our 10,000 observations are counted in each of the bin slots. We can transfer this frequency per bucket into a percentage of the 10,000 data points. Of course, the percentages will add up to 100%. The last thing we need to do is to create a graph. We highlight the bin range, hold down the control key, and highlight the percentage range and click on the insert graph. And here is our normal distribution. In this video, we have given some background on the normal distribution. We have seen the relationship between the distribution surface and the cumulative percentages which represent a data frequency. We also understand the relationship between these percentages and the x-axis values and how we can define this in Excel using the normal distribution function and the normal distribution inverse function. Finally, we created a graph using simulated results and the Excel frequency function. Thanks for watching and good luck.